The following program, paid for by RightPath Real Estate, does not necessarily represent the views or opinions of the staff, management, or ownership of this station. It's time to get on the right path with RightPath Real Estate Radio with Tom Perry. Get the answer to your question that's keeping you from taking action and succeeding today. Get ready. The guide that will put your fears behind you is on the air now. Taking calls at 713-785-1817. Toll free 877-881-0271. Now here's your host, Tom Perry.
Hey, welcome to the show. Welcome to the show. I feel like a one-armed paper hanger when I'm starting the show because, you know, although my producer Rick does a very fine job of getting the show up and going on AM 1110, but we also broadcast live on the Book of Faces at fb.com/RightPath Real Estate. We also then start broadcasting on Instagram and Twitch and Periscope and all of that. And so just, you know, starting everything all at once, two computers, two cameras, you know, everything going through the feed. And so welcome to the show. That's all I can say. So for those of y'all who don't know the story, I talk about, by the way, my name's Tom Perry. I'm the host of the Right Path Real Estate Radio Show. Normally I'm joined in the studio by either a guest like on Build Our Team Thursday or my brother from another mother, Mr. Daniel G. But he's actually on his way to Dallas today. He's going to do a live show later on today on Propelio TV. And I believe it's the Pains and Gains show or Gains and Pains show, something like that. And so he's leaving north side of Houston right now as we speak, so probably listening on the AM dial or maybe even following it on Facebook. He and his wife were going up there, coming back. And then we're going to be doing our Wealth Through Real Estate Academy tomorrow and Sunday. And I want to pour into someone else's life. I want to throw it out there right now that if you would like to learn how to buy, fix, and flip, like learn how to wholesale, learn how to buy and hold, I've got one free ticket left. I earlier in the week, I made an offer, three free tickets. All you got to do is make an application. You know, what we do is we interview people for this process. In fact, to work with us, we interview people. This isn't a run to the back of the room, sign up, you know, run your credit card, things like that. We want to build success for people in their life. Most people don't focus on the right end of the problem. So many people want to focus on doing something different so that you have something different. In fact, I see so many people in life that really focus on what's happened in their past. What I can tell you is if you think about your life like a car, and I want you to notice the way that a car is designed. Every car has a rearview mirror, but in comparison to the size of the windshield, the rearview mirror is relatively small. You should stay more focused on where you're going, what direction you're heading, and every now and then it's important to glance back, see where you've been, but your past does not equal your future. You know, the great thing that I recognize about the human spirit, the human condition, is that we all have the ability to improve our skill set. If you don't like where you are in life, start surrounding yourself with people that are where you want to be in life. When you start hanging around with the kind of people that you want to be like, the future you, that's going to draw you to accountability. It's going to draw you to the type of person that you want to be in the future. Because it's, I tell you what, it's the daily disciplines in life that make the difference. It's the way that we think that leads to our decisions, that leads to our doing, which leads to our results. But it always begins with the thoughts. And I've discovered over time that many, many people don't focus on how they think. In fact, if I give people a very simple A-B choice, like, hey, would you rather make 10% on your money or would you rather make 30% on your money? I mean, almost everybody is going to choose 30%, absent, you know, anything else. Any other variables in that, right? Just looking at those two choices, you know, A versus B, 10 versus 30. Yeah, sign me up for 30, right? Only thing better than signing up for 30 would be signing up for 31. But it's amazing how so few people actually do the math. I mean, just very few people have ever done the math. I mean, I got involved in a conversation yesterday with a gentleman that really wants to do note buying as opposed to buy and hold. And his number one reason why is because he doesn't want to deal with tenants. And I said, well, I don't want to deal with tenants either. That's why I have Jerry Ta as a property manager. I mean, $85 a month per door. A little bit of a discount if you've got a duplex, a triplex, or a quadplex. But, I mean, $85 a door and you don't have to deal with the tenants. Imagine this. I'll just, in a nutshell, compare for you notes versus buying the real estate. If I started today with a $10 million portfolio of notes and a $10 million portfolio of single-family houses that I own, in 30 years, my notes are worth zero. My houses are probably worth $20 million, $25 million, $30 million, something like that. The asset of the single-family house appreciates about 7% per year. And one of the things that we teach in our weekend Wealth Through Real Estate Academy is leveraging appreciation. So in other words, if it appreciates 7% a year and you're leveraged 5 to 1, you'll get 35% appreciation. Ben asked a question, way you do one thing is the way, yeah, oh yeah, the way you do one thing is the way you do all things. That's correct. Yes, I'll agree with that. In principle, yes. So since houses appreciate, when I sell the note, now don't get me wrong, banks make a lot of money, like Chase Bank. You know, they borrow money at, you know, LIBOR, whatever that dollar amount is, and they lend it out at a higher rate. They make an interest rate arbitrage, and then they also, so if you've ever looked at, if you borrow $200,000 to buy a house and you pay it off over 30 years and you look at how much you pay off over that time period, yes, Chase Mortgage does very, very well, but at the end of the 30 years, that asset is gone. It's not worth anything. They don't get to participate in the appreciation. That house that's worth $200,000 today in 30 years is not worth $200,000. It's worth $400,000, $500,000, could be $600,000. And what's fascinating is that Chase doesn't get to benefit any from that. They've received monthly payments along the way, but they don't get to benefit from the appreciation. And if you're buying notes, you don't either. Now, you can buy notes at a discount, and I get all of that. I understand the math. But when I compare the math of that versus the math of... Now, is there a reason to buy notes? Yes. Is there a reason to buy subject to and then do a seller finance wrap? Yeah, there's a reason. I mean, I've got a deal like that right now. It's in a part of town that I didn't want to own a rental, wouldn't ever want to own a rental. My best exit strategy was to do a seller finance wrap. Do I want to do that with my entire portfolio? No, I don't. But be willing to learn the math. The math is pretty simple. It's one of the things that we spend a lot of time on at the Wealth Through Real Estate Academy is the math. We have someone that's coming this weekend, I know, that wants to learn how to estimate rehabs. You know, after, you know, starting Fast Track from scratch, being the founder of Fast Track and starting with just a crew of four guys and reverse engineering and figuring out what it takes to estimate rehabs and do all of that, it's pretty amazing to me that you can estimate a rehab, you can learn how to estimate a rehab in less than 10 minutes. And get within 10%. Will you be right on the money? Will you be spot on? No, you won't be exact. But what I can tell you is it doesn't really matter if you're exact. What matters is, do you have enough information to make the decision on pulling the trigger? We had a great event last night. It was our case study event. Joe shared his story, two of his properties out of the 11 that he's bought. He's bought and sold a lot more than that, but he's got 11 rentals, and he shared the first two that he bought. And kind of what he acquired them for and what they're worth today and what he put in them and all of those kind of things. And, you know, great story. And over and over and over with a lot of our students that were in the room last night, you know, the light bulbs are going off with the thinking, realizing that, hey, like one of the properties that he was talking about is a property bought 7 years ago back in 2012. And he's looking at what he was able to pay for those properties. And you can't buy those same properties in those same neighborhoods for those same prices. Not now, not ever. Those days are gone. And looking back on it, you know, his big regret is, oh my gosh, I wish I'd have bought not just one or two back then, but I wish I'd bought like 20.
2 minutes.
Because the appreciation has been so fantastic. And he shared, you know, some of the real thought process, you know, just the mental angst and anguish back in 2012 when he was just kind of going back and forth, you know, like, should I offer 72 or should I offer 71.5 or should I offer 73? Because the guy was asking like 75 and like he didn't want to offer full price because he was looking for a deal. And that property today, in its current condition, is worth like $180. But what he did is he's put some extra money into the property, selling it for $240. A property that was in for $72 back in 2012 and put $12,000 in it. And now that it's appreciated up to $180,000 in a rental state condition, it's worth even more in a flip state condition. So he decided, hey, instead of selling for 180 as is, let's put some extra money in it. And I think he's putting $25,000 or maybe $30,000. Gonna sell it for $240. Comps strongly support $240. Done up nice. Some neighborhoods you can see that. Done up nice, you get this. Not so nice, you get this other. He did the math. He did the research. So can you imagine buying a house for 72, putting 12 in? You're all in for 84. 7 years later, put another 30 in, sell it for 240. Make over 100,000 in 7 years. What if you did that 10 times over the next 7 years? That's a ticket to $1 million over 7 years. The music says I'm out of time. I'll be back in 4 minutes. Stay tuned. I'll be right back.
Real estate investors, do you need a lender that moves fast at the speed of a jet to fund your investment properties? Jet Lending will help you purchase properties quickly with as little cash out of pocket as possible. Jet Lending also sets up a repair escrow fund to help you with repair costs. Jet Lending has originated over 2,000 loans in Texas valued at over $250 million. Jet Lending will help you evaluate your deals for free and give you feedback on value, cost of repairs, and potential loan amount. Jet Lending is your fast and friendly hard money source for first-time investors and seasoned professionals. Call 281-872-7800 or email us at info@jetlending.com. Oh, and don't forget about our famous Third Wednesday Super Investor Networking Meeting. Lots of fun, lots of great real estate talk. We'll see you there.
Time is money in a real estate deal. If your insurance company is slow or non-responsive, you could lose a deal like that. You need a quick turnaround on quotes, binders, and the agency for that is Benchmark Insurance Group of Texas. The team at Benchmark understands the investor mindset. They know what you need and when you need it. It's there for you. Call Houston's leading real estate risk management experts. Benchmark Insurance Group of Texas. 281-569-4353. That's 281-569-4353. Or online at benchmarkbroker.com.
Are you looking for an investor-friendly general contractor for your investment property? Then call Fast Track Remodeling at 832-742-9992 or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
Fast Track Remodeling specializes in turnkey remodeling of single-family investment properties. Whether it's a flip rehab or a rental rehab, we manage every aspect of a rehab from start to finish with a highly efficient, standardized process.
Over the last 6 years, Fast Track has completed over 700 projects, which has helped us to create our three keys to success. Use a detailed scope of work so that everything gets done, train and maintain quality crews so it gets done right, and complete the work in a proper order so it gets done fast.
No more managing it yourself, no more doing the work yourself. Fast Track Remodeling really does manage it all.
So give us a call today at 832-742-9992. Again, that's 832-742-9992 or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
1 minute.
All right.
Do you have cracks in your brick, doors that stick, or sheetrock that's coming apart? Then you may have foundation movement. Due to our expansive soils in the Houston area, it's probably not a question of if you have movement, but when. Call Foundation Check for a truly independent, unbiased foundation evaluation. Foundation Check has been in business since 2009 and has completed over 1,400 evaluations. We're not in the business of repairing foundations or selling you unnecessary peer work, but we are in the business of evaluating your foundation. Our product is designed for house flippers, landlords, or even owner-occupied properties. Each of our files is reviewed by a licensed engineer. Remember to check before every repair. Call 346-702-3825. That's 346-702-3825.
Morning, Paul.
Or you can reach us online at foundationcheck.com. That's foundationcheck.com.
This is Business 1110.
Mic's on.
Hey, welcome back, Right Path Real Estate Radio. I'm in the studio by myself. Feels a little bit weird. I've done this show so many times by myself, but I've kind of gotten the habit. It's fun to do it with Daniel G, but he is on the road to Dallas, Texas, to do an event with Propelio TV, and so that'll be later on this afternoon. He posted, if you're following along, go to facebook.com/RightPathRealEstate. In the comment section, he's posted the video page and all that where Propelio TV is, so you can watch that later on this afternoon. Then he's coming back tonight. We've got our weekend event this weekend. It's the Wealth Through Real Estate Academy. It's where we teach what we've done in Houston House Buyers, how we started it, how much we started it with, how we bought fixed and flipped houses, how we wholesaled houses, how we did buy and hold, how we did it when we started back in 2013, and what we would do differently, knowing what we know now. So we teach you about the marketing. We'll teach you about estimating rehabs. We teach you about all the, really everything that it takes to run it as a business, how we think about the business as a business, not just as a transaction, but as a business. And then, Daniel, thanks for sharing that. At 2:30 today, Propelio TV is going to be live streaming, so I'll be watching that. I actually have an appointment to walk a house today at 1 o'clock, so that'll probably be from 1 to 2, and I'm trying to schedule a meeting at about 2:30 with the gentleman that walked a house on Monday, made an offer, he accepted, we contracted and all that. We're going to do a follow-up meeting with him today, and then the rest of the afternoon, going to try and spend with family so I can rest up for this weekend, so that I can train minds full of mush, as Rush would say. You know, all I'm trying to do is give back. You know, nothing makes me more excited than to see our students winning. And, I know we have Matt, for example, down in Corpus that, you know, got started, was doing a little bit before he came to us, had gone to another real estate education group, was trying to apply what they taught, but it really wasn't working for him. He was stuck. He didn't really know how to get unstuck. Then he joined us at our weekend, got involved at our base camp level, and then started taking action. And it's exciting to see that he's grown his net worth over $600,000 in like the last 3 years. Not in a big market like Houston either. I mean, he's really in the outskirts of Corpus Christi. But we have students doing that in Houston. We have students doing that in Dallas. We have students doing that all over the country. Because when you understand the process, when you understand the plan, when you understand the system, and you just put it into action, it becomes duplicatable, repeatable, a process. And the question just becomes, do you work the process or do you try and vary the process? You know, we don't try and reinvent the wheel every single time. What we do is we understand the numbers. We understand why the numbers are the numbers. You know, I made an offer on a house. See, this must have been Wednesday. And I got to my number based on the condition of the house. And I'll share my number. It was $35,000 for this particular house. Because it needs probably $70,000 of the work. And so, you know, the people weren't thrilled with that number. But they asked me, hey, do you have any wiggle room in that number? And I'm like, I mean, maybe a little bit. I mean, if you're asking, can I get to 50? The answer is no. I mean, I'll walk away. Can I get to 35.5? Can I get to 36? I mean, if I can have a quick decision, then yeah, I'll go to 36. If you're not going to decide today, then I'm at 35. Because if you don't decide today, then I've got to spend a lot of time, energy, and effort following up and following up and following up and following up. And that costs money. Because it costs time. And so what I recognize is that the value of the property is only going to get worse over time. I mean, there were seven different holes in the roof. One of them probably, I don't know, 6-8 feet in diameter. So every time it rains, water just pours in this particular room. So there's mildew in the room and all that. It needs everything. New kitchens, new baths, new everything. It's probably $30 to $40 a foot on a 1,500 square foot house, plus a new roof, plus HVAC. Copper's been stolen out. I mean, it's bad. But what happens is when you start understanding the numbers, you get real confident that I don't care if I get the deal or not. What I care about is whether or not I get the deal at the right price. Because I'm not willing to overpay just to get the deal. And I recognize that 90% of all, in fact, probably 99% of all investors, if they walk through that house, it would scare them away. There's probably not 10 investors in the whole city that this house wouldn't scare them away. And all of those people would be probably within $500 of what my number is. So by learning the math, by learning the process, by learning the system, and doing it over and over and over again, you gain this confidence where you just realize, hey, this is my number. And I'm not willing. I remember there was a property down in Point Comfort that I talked about. And I really didn't want to do a deal down in Point Comfort, which is, for a lot of y'all, are like, where's Point Comfort? Well, it's just outside of Port Lavaca. And some of y'all don't know where that is. And so probably the closest larger town. If you go south on the Southwest Freeway from Houston towards Victoria. If you lived in Victoria and wanted to go to the beach, probably the closest beach you could go to would be Port Lavaca. So just draw a straight line from Victoria to the Gulf Coast, just perpendicular to the coastline. You're in Port Lavaca. So Port Lavaca is actually on the south side of this body of water called Lavaca Bay. On the north side of Lavaca Bay is Point Comfort. And there was this three-bedroom, one-bath house that I'm like, man, I think it's worth like maybe 80 if it's all fixed up. So, you know, 70% of that's like 56. Probably needs $20 a foot in rehab, and it's like 1,200 square feet. So subtract 24,000. I'm like, okay, so that puts me maybe like at 32. But do I want it at 32? No, because I mean, I can't send Fast Track down there. They're not going to go down to Point Comfort. So I've got to find somebody locally. What if they're more expensive? So my, you know, 24,000 in rehab is now 30,000. So there's an extra $6,000 just because I've got to deal with local folks that I don't know. I don't have that relationship, all that kind of stuff. And so that takes, so now I'm down to 26. But I like to automate the process. How much of my time is it going to take? How many trips am I going to have to make down there? And it's like 2 hours one way. How many 4-hour round trips? How convenient is that going to be? I don't really want it at 24. I don't really want it at 15. I mean, finally, I end up having a conversation with a seller after I, you know, see the house, and I said, "Look, I mean, best case scenario, I'm like at like 12, and I'm not done doing my due diligence. I mean, should I go ahead and close the file? Should I even keep going? Should we even keep talking?" She goes, "Yeah, let's keep talking. Keep doing your due diligence." She had wanted like 30. And I'm like, yeah, I can't get to your number. There's just no way. Just no way I can get to your number. I'm like 12 best case scenario. Should we even keep talking? Yeah, let's keep talking. So I was like, oh, man. Now what do I do? Well, I kept – now I realize from a sales standpoint, I mean, she's at least considering 12, but I'm not sure I want it at 12. And so finally, I got real comfortable with the fact that I really don't want this property very bad. And so at some number, what number would make me want it? I mean, there's some number in your head that when you get a property like that, you go, you know what? If I just throw this number out there as a flyer, and if they take it, it's like, oh, dang it, they took it. And if they don't, it's like, oh, well, they didn't, you know. And my number for that was $9,000. I was willing to do the deal if I could buy it for $9,000. So I called her up and I said, look, I did more research. I can't get to the 12 we were talking about before. I'm at 9. And I even told her, I said, quite honestly, I don't care if you take the offer or you don't. If you don't, it's like, oh, well, I dodged a bullet. If you take it, I'm like, oh, now I've got to actually do something with this. She goes, well, let me call my sister who lives in Colorado. I'm like, all right, yeah, phone a friend. Well, what it is she had inherited the property, and so her sister was part owner. So she and her sister are splitting the $9,000. You never know what people will say yes to. They said yes. We bought it for $9,000. But the point of that whole story is just to say that it's when you're dealing with properties that are some of the worst. This house, oh my God, the smell. You know, I've smelled a lot of nasty houses, but there's just something about, you know, excessive cat smell that is, oh, it's that's something special. I'll tell you that. Special, not in a good way. Yeah. I've gotten where I carry as my in my toolkit. In the trunk of my car, I carry one of those masks that has the charcoal filters, one of the paint sprayer masks. You can walk in, it covers the full face, covers the mouth and the nose. You can't smell anything. I had to walk the house with that. I felt sorry for the real estate agent that was showing. They hadn't listed the property, but there was an agent that had been managing the property, was willing to at least show the property to anybody because all the owners lived out of town. So when they said yes to the $9,000, then what do you do? Now you've got to have a process.
2 minutes.
How do you go into another market that you're not currently in? If you have the systems and the processes in place, you can take your systems and processes, and if you know how to build relationships, that's really what you're looking for. This is a relationship business. When you recognize it's not about getting the best deal, it's about building relationships with people. So I built a relationship with a local real estate agent. I'm a licensed agent, but I don't want to list a property down in Point Comfort. What I want to do is I want to find one of the top agents that does this. Turns out that top agent is also an investor. He does flips down in Point Comfort. So guess who he knows? He's built relationships with contractors and roofers and air conditioning people and all of that. Yeah. So I leveraged his relationships. You can either build your own relationships or you can leverage someone else's.
1 minute.
It's one of the things that we have in our vendor program. When you listen to our, you know, radio show sponsors like Benchmark Insurance or Fast Track or Property Care or Patton Law Firm, these are relationships, people that we've done business with for the last, you know, 9 or 10 years. You get to leverage those relationships. You don't have to start from scratch. They go, oh, you're with Right Path. Oh, yeah, we know you know what you're doing. What it does is it gets you out of the starting gates quicker. How quickly would you start if you knew that you could not fail? You're listening to Right Path Real Estate Radio, 713-785-1817. If you want to give us a call, the music says I'm out of time. I talk between the music. Stay with me. I'll be back in 4 minutes.
Do you have cracks in your brick, doors that stick, or sheetrock that's coming apart? Then you may have foundation movement. Due to our expansive soils in the Houston area, it's probably not a question of if you have movement, but when. Call Foundation Check for a truly independent, unbiased foundation evaluation. Foundation Check has been in business since 2009 and has completed over 1,400 evaluations. We're not in the business of repairing foundations or selling you unnecessary peer work, but we are in the business of evaluating your foundation. Our product is designed for house flippers, landlords, or even owner-occupied properties. Each of our files is reviewed by a licensed engineer. Remember to check before every repair. Call 346-702-3825. That's 346-702-3825. Or you can reach us online at foundationcheck.com. That's foundationcheck.com.
Hello, real estate investors. Do you need a lender that moves fast at the speed of a jet to fund your investment properties? Jet Lending will help you purchase properties quickly with as little cash out of pocket as possible. Jet Lending also sets up a repair escrow fund to help you with repair costs. Jet Lending has originated over 2,000 loans in Texas valued at over $250 million. Jet Lending will help you evaluate your deals for free and give you feedback on value, cost of repairs, and potential loan amount. Jet Lending is your fast and friendly hard money source for first-time investors and seasoned professionals. Call 281-872-7800 or email us at info@jetlending.com. Oh, and don't forget about our famous Third Wednesday Super Investor Networking Meeting. Lots of fun, lots of great real estate talk. We'll see you there.
What's up, Instagram folks? Ted, Jaja. Man, some of these names are...
Time is money in real estate deals. If your insurance company is slow or non-responsive, you could lose a deal like that.
Apricot,
you need a quick turnaround on quotes or binders. The agency for that is Benchmark Insurance Group of Texas. The team at Benchmark understands the investor mindset. They know what you need and when you need it. We're here for you. Are you a rehabber, wholesaler, buy and hold, or flipper? Bundling your properties on a single policy will help save time and money. Benchmark has been in business for over 10 years, and we insure over 30,000 properties. Contact Benchmark about our exclusive investor package. Call us and let us show you what we can do for you at 281-569-4353. That's 281-569-4353. Or online at benchmarkbroker.com. That's benchmarkbroker.com. That's 281-569-4353. Or online at benchmarkbroker.com.
Are you looking for an investor-friendly general contractor for your investment property? Then call Fast Track Remodeling at 832-742-9992 or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
Fast Track Remodeling specializes in turnkey remodeling of single-family investment properties. Whether it's a flip rehab or a rental rehab, we manage every aspect of a rehab from start to finish with a highly efficient, standardized process.
Over the last 6 years, Fast Track has completed over 700 projects, which has helped us to create our three keys to success. Use a detailed scope of work so that everything gets done, train and maintain quality crews so it gets done right, and complete the work in a proper order so it gets done fast.
No more managing it yourself, no more doing the work yourself. Fast Track Remodeling really does manage it all.
So give us a call today at 832-742-9992. Again, that's 832-742-9992 or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
This is Business 1110.
Okay, mic's on.
Hey, welcome back. Welcome back. Right Path Real Estate Radio, 713-785-1817. If you want to give us a call, if you want to talk about anything related to real estate, single family, you want to talk about buy and hold, you want to talk about buy, fix, and flip, you want to talk about wholesaling. In fact, if you want to talk about things that aren't single family, I can explain to you why I don't do some of the other businesses. At our Wealth Through Real Estate workshop that we had last night, we had a Wealth Through Real Estate workshop, and we had a case study, and we had base camp going on all, not exactly simultaneously, but we were juggling a lot of events. So it was a great time. Lots of information being shared and things like that. But, you know, it's interesting that a lot of people confuse certain aspects of real estate with businesses that just happen to have real estate. And let me explain. So imagine that I wanted to open up a restaurant. You know, you have to understand what it takes to run a successful business, and the business is being in the restaurant business, right? Now, most people wouldn't consider opening, starting, running a restaurant a real estate play. Because I'm in the business of providing food prepared, you know, and service and all that, whether it's takeout, whether it's taco truck, whatever it is, I'm providing food to people, right? And so if that business, let's say it gets built up, it's very successful, it grows and grows and grows, and eventually I want to sell it, there's going to be a valuation on the business based on the profit that it makes. So you have to learn how to evaluate businesses like that. Now, we all recognize that most business, unless it is a taco truck, which, you know, you've got the truck, there's no real estate involved, it's just the truck. You've got a vehicle, right, that's registered. Could be a trailer, right? But most businesses are a piece of real estate. And if you own the piece of real estate, let's say you open up a barbecue place and it's on some land and in a building, you know, it's a restaurant business. It's not a real estate business. It's not a real estate play. Now, the fact that there's real estate is just kind of secondary to the fact that it's a business. And what I would submit to you is that when you're looking at multifamily, for example, as an investment, that it's less about being a piece of real estate and more about the business. That's how they're evaluated. The valuation of a multifamily, you don't comp it the same way that you comp a single-family piece of property. because I can compare what I buy a piece of property with compared to what a retail end user owner occupant. I can get an appraisal like that. The value of a multifamily, it's hard to comp. So I'm looking at a piece of property right now, and I can draw a quarter mile radius, and I can get 30, 40, 50 sold over the last, let's say, 180 to 365 days. You can't do that with a lot of multifamily. Because and if I'm comping it, I'm looking, you know, plus or minus about 2 to 3 years of build, and within about 100 or 200 square feet of the size and exactly the number of bedrooms and bathrooms and things like that. So I can see exact comps that allow me to infer valuations identical to what I'm doing. It's really easy to determine valuations, Multifamily, not so much. Office buildings, not so much. I mean, I'm in a great office building right now. Our offices are over between Terry Hershey Park and BP Way, between Memorial Drive and I-10. It's a beautiful piece of wooded piece of property. Got a lake on it, a 310,000 square foot office building, three stories, parking down below, parking up above. Nothing else like it in all of Houston. I mean, I know a lot of office buildings. I've been a native Houstonian, lived here all my life. It's not another piece of property exactly like this. So how do you determine what it's worth? Well, a lot of people, it's how much cash is it generating? What can it generate? It's a business of officing people, which is different than the way you would evaluate a single-family piece of real estate. So I can be in the business of being a landlord, but that's an actual real estate investment. It's about what's the value of the piece of real estate. Multifamily, commercial, retail, strip shopping centers, all of that kind of stuff is going to be based on the business. How much revenue does it produce? And then what's the cap rate on that revenue? That's how it's evaluated. So you have to look at what kind of business do I want to be in? And are you looking at it because you're saying, hey, I want to get in real estate, I want to do X, Y, and Z? I would say that the only, you know, real business that's real estate is single-family houses. Multifamily, and I know it's kind of controversial to say that multifamily is not real estate, but it's really less about the bricks and the sticks and the roof and the foundation and all that. It's really more, now condition matters and all that, but it's really more about what's the business that you're going to do. You're going to be in the business of housing people, for monthly rent. That's the business that you're in. So it's how much revenue can I produce? I've got 200 doors, and then go and rent for, you know, let's say they're all two bedroom, one bath, and let's say that the rent goes for, you know, $1,000 a month per unit. So I can look at, well, if it's fully occupied, what's the best case scenario that I can get for rent? So that'd be 200 times 1,000. Yeah, $200,000 a month in revenue. What else can I do to enhance revenue? Well, maybe I have washers and dryers. Maybe I have Coke machines. Maybe I have, you know, other things like that, some value adds. Maybe I charge for parking spaces, for premium spaces, things like that. So you can calculate what's the revenue that I can get. And the value of the property is based on what's the revenue minus what are the expenses? What are my property taxes? What's my insurance? What's my maintenance cost? Do I have a property manager on site? Do I have leasing people? How much do they get? Do they get paid on a salary? So you subtract all those expenses. So let's say out of $200,000 a month, let's say I've got $50,000 a month in expenses. Might even be more than that. So people are going to say, well, how much would I pay for that kind of revenue stream? And what it really looks at is the cap rate. And a cap rate is as simple as understanding if I went down and put $100,000 in a savings account, what rate of interest would they pay? Let's say it's 2%. Well, that would be like a 2 cap. Means if I wanted to make $1 million in income a year on a 2 cap, it takes 50 times that. In terms of investment, I'd have to have $100 million. Excuse me, I'd have to have $50 million. Sorry, at 2%, $50 million earning 2% gives me $1 million a year. $50 million at 2% makes me $1 million a year. So if you're investing at a 2 cap, that's a pretty low interest. It's a pretty low rate of return. What we're seeing right now in multifamily, we're seeing 4 caps. And what a lot of investors don't realize is that a 4 cap only works when your cost of capital is low. Most people that own multifamily Class A properties, they have a very, very low cost of capital. You look at somebody like Blackstone, and they've got a 1% cost of capital. They can invest at 4%. Imagine if you could borrow at 1, you invest at 4, you're making 3%. Let's do it on $1 billion. 3% on $1 billion is pretty good money. If you don't have a 1% cost of capital, I recommend you don't invest at 4%. Unless you have a lot of capital you want to deploy that's your money already, that you've created wealth, those kind of returns are great ways to park money safely and securely. Dr. Dotsark was in town last week. He was speaking at the Redneck Country Club on Wednesday at the Super Investor meeting. And one of the things that he's sharing is that, you know, there's a lot of wealthy people in places like Germany and Japan. And if they want to park a lot of money safely and securely, one place to do it is government bonds. You can put money in, you know, government bonds in Germany and Japan. They have a negative interest rate right now. In other words, you invest $1 million with them, they charge you 1%. 1% on $1 million is about $10,000. At the end of a year, you don't have $1 million, you've got $990. But your $990 is safe and secure. It's not going anywhere. I mean, that's one way to do it. So compared to a negative 1%, I mean, heck, 4% looks really, really good. But for the average investor out there that's looking to build wealth, not looking to park wealth, there's a difference between what do you do once you've created your wealth and now you're looking to park it versus I want to create wealth. And I believe that one of the best ways to create wealth is in single-family real estate. Because we're not talking about 4% rates of return. We're talking about if you're parking capital, about 15% on the low side between cash flow and appreciation. 7% appreciation on a $150,000 house, 7 or 8% cash flow on a $150,000 house. You pay $150,000 for it, it's move-in ready, rents for $1,500 a month. You'll make about 8% cash-on-cash return on your rents. After you pay taxes, insurance, some miscellaneous fees, property management, you'll make about 8%. However, where I get excited, leveraged appreciation. Dr. Dotsauer talked about bulletproof investing. And bulletproof investing is, he didn't want to have, you know, leverage is good, but can you over-leverage? Yes. How he defines over-leveraging. Remember the apartment complex. Let's say we have 200 doors, $1,000 a month in rent.
1 minute.
It's $200,000 in revenue coming in monthly if you've got 100% occupancy. It's hard to maintain 100% occupancy, I'll tell you that. So he said, what if whatever number you have as standard occupancy in historically, if that were to drop 10 to 12% and rental rates were to drop 10%, could my monthly coming in cover my debt service? No money left over going in my pocket, but if I can survive a downturn like that, then I'll survive the 2 years of recession. Then the 8 years of uptick after the recession that takes place where valuations explode. That's when I'll build wealth. The music says I'm out of time. I'll be back in 4 minutes. You're listening to Right Path Real Estate Radio, 713-785-1817 if you want to give us a call. Hey, good morning, Ginger.
Time is money in a real estate deal. If your insurance company is slow or non-responsive, you could lose a deal like that. You need a quick turnaround on quotes or binders? The agency for that is Benchmark Insurance Group of Texas. The team at Benchmark understands the investor mindset. They know what you need and when you need it. We're here for you. Are you a rehabber, wholesaler, buy and hold, or flipper? Bundling your properties on a single policy will help save time and money. Benchmark has been in business for over 10 years, and we insure over 30,000 properties. Contact Benchmark about our exclusive investor package. Call us and let us show you what we can do for you at 281-569-4353. That's 281-569-4353. Or online at benchmarkbroker.com. That's benchmarkbroker.com. That's 281-569-4353. Or online at benchmarkbroker.com.
Are you looking for an investor-friendly general contractor for your investment property? Then call Fast Track Remodeling at 832-742-9992 or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
Fast Track Remodeling specializes in turnkey remodeling of single-family investment properties. Whether it's a flip rehab or a rental rehab, we manage every aspect of a rehab from start to finish with a highly efficient, standardized process.
Over the last 6 years, Fast Track has completed over 700 projects, which has helped us to create our three keys to success. Use a detailed scope of work so that everything gets done, train and maintain quality crews so it gets done right, and complete the work in a proper order so it gets done fast.
No more managing it yourself, no more doing the work yourself. Fast Track Remodeling really does manage it all.
So give us a call today at 832-742-9992. Again, that's 832-742-9992, or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
Selecting a foundation company and their product for repair is a lot like a game of chance. You simply don't know what you're going to get. The foundation repair industry as a whole doesn't carry a license, nor is it regulated. However, Foundation Check utilizes professional engineers to review all of our files to give you the best foundation analysis in today's market. Remember to check before every repair. Call 346-702-3825, or you can reach us online at foundationcheck.com.
This is Business 1110.
Mike's on.
Hey, welcome back. Welcome back. Right Path Real Estate Radio. My name is Tom Perry. I'm the host of the show. I own Houston House Buyers, and I also own another company called Quality Property Solutions, and we're actively buying real estate on a daily basis. We buy, fix, and flip. We wholesale. We also buy and hold, and I teach you how to do the same. We do single-family buy and hold. Single-family, also duplex, triplex, fourplex. Going to close on a fourplex. If not next week, it'll be the week following. I believe that I'll be able to get it done by Friday of next week. And, you know, sweet little deal. Be able to share the numbers after I close on it. But, you know, it's a fourplex that has a unit that is two-bedroom, two-bath, a unit that's two-bedroom, one-bath, and then two one-bedroom, one-baths.
And, Tom, you got a call.
Oh, yeah? Well, let's take the call because I've only got a few minutes. Let's do it. Who's the caller?
And a very good I was calling, researching some of these tax deed properties, just if you had any advice as far as are there pitfalls to the tax deed sale, looking them up, doing a title search and all that.
Yeah, absolutely.
Do you recommend
buying
a house on a tax deed?
Yeah, so you're talking about buying a property at the tax auction, correct? Because the first Tuesday of every month in the state of Texas, there's two auctions that take place. One is the trustee auction, which is where the mortgage foreclosures, HOA foreclosures, all that take place. So that's a trustee auction. The other is a constable sale. And so, yes, there are some pitfalls for that. So especially if your strategy is to flip a property. Are you flipping properties, or are you wanting to do buy and hold?
I can buy and hold, but honestly, I want to get paid. That would be the ideal, but I could put up some cash to do that.
So here's the downside. Most title companies, there's two things you have to recognize. When you buy a piece of property and it's been foreclosed on for not paying back taxes, then that person that basically got the property taken away from them, if it's not their homestead, they have 6 months to redeem that property. So if you go in there, you want to do some repairs, things like that. If they're not necessary repairs, then that person can redeem the property and they don't have to pay you for those repairs. If it's necessary for the safety of the structure, you can be reimbursed for that. Now, they have to reimburse you at the price that you paid plus a 25% premium. So you do make a little bit of money back, but someone else can come along and actually buy their redemption rights. So there's some risk there. If it is a homestead, they have 2 years to reclaim it. So imagine you go in, you do a whole lot of stuff, you put a tenant in there and all that, and somebody comes along, buys their redemption rights, takes it away from you. Last but not least, there's a statute of limitations for something called wrongful foreclosure. So keep in mind that this is a mill, right? Limebarger Goggin is one of the law firms that does the foreclosure process. They make mistakes sometimes. The family that gets the property taken away from them, they have the right to sue, saying, hey, guys, y'all didn't do this properly. We didn't get right notice, all that. They can unwind all those things. The statute of limitations for that is 4 years. So many title companies will not insure the title for 4 years from the time that it's sold at the auction, because they want to go the greatest risk for them is that four-year period. So, yes, there are some risks. I'm not a big fan of buying at the tax auction.
Wow. So just kind of buy and hold, and if the numbers work after several years, it would make sense to fix it. And
correct. After 4 years, that's exactly right. Yeah.
Well, I think thank you so much for the education.
Yeah, absolutely. I think there's better ways. Keep in mind, if you're in Houston, we teach some of those processes through our Wealth Through Real Estate Academy, and we're doing that this weekend. So thanks so much for joining us. All right, so in the last minute that I have to go, just want to tell you that I've got one ticket left. If you want to email support@rightpathrealestate.com, that's support@rightpathrealestate.com. If you want to come to our Wealth Through Real Estate Academy, in the title line, put free ticket. Daniel's going to get to that. Also, 2:30 today, don't forget to watch him on Propelio TV. If you go to fb.com and like our Right Path Real Estate page, fb.com/Right Path Real Estate, you can see our page and scroll through there, or just email support@rightpathrealestate.com, and you can get a link for that Propelio TV. Daniel's going to be live on that at 2:30 today. He's going to be a great guest. You definitely want to watch that. So other than that, subject line. Thanks for sharing that, Andy. And if you'll do that on Instagram as well. So Instagram folks, y'all need to know that. Facebook folks, y'all have it right there. Just put in the subject line, free ticket. Go to support@rightpathrealestate.com. And Daniel will take care of you on that. So it's Saturday from 9 to 5. It's Sunday from 9 to 5. And I teach you all the different ways, the eight different processes that we use for – there's eight modules that we recognize that you have to master in order to be successful at this business. There's so many different ways. Here's what I can tell you is that was a great question, the caller that called up and asked. Because I see every single week – advertisements for how to buy at the tax auction. And I think, oh my gosh, somebody's teaching that from out of state that doesn't do it right here in Texas, then they don't know the pitfalls. Learn from somebody that's doing it right here in Houston, doing it in your own backyard. We do it every single day. Thanks for listening, guys. Have a great weekend. God bless. We love you. See you. Bye-bye.
You've been listening to Right Path Real Estate Radio. Find Tom at rightpathrealestate.com.
Thanks, you too. Bye-bye.
You can put the fear behind you and listen every day from 9 to 10 a.m.
Instagram folks.
On Business 1110.
Thanks, Facebook folks.
KTEK.